Thank you for joining me today. My name is Joseph Jassey. I'm a senior program manager here at Microsoft in the Employee Experience and Platforms team. In today's conversation, I am going to talk about how Microsoft uses technology to improve the employee experiences. There are a lot of stories to share, but for this conversation, I'm going to focus on these three experiences: our Manager Hub transformation, time and absence reporting application, and our Manager Hub, and how that is empowering managers to be at their best. Every company going through a digital transformation will drive innovation to engage customers, transform their products, optimize their operations, or empower their employees. Technology doesn't just work. People need to be introduced to the technology changes to help them understand how it will affect them and why they should change in the first place. With a shift to the cloud, many processes and organizational changes are required. In order for any innovation to flourish, though, successful change requires these three elements, and that is the people, the process, and technology. For us here at Microsoft, our culture is very important to us. Our growth mindset approach would apply to three areas: being more customer obsessed, being more diverse and inclusive, and being open to your own biases and showing up as one Microsoft. Once we landed on the growth mindset and the three areas, Satya declared it on June 25th, 2015, at this company meeting where he stated that this is our culture. He then went on to our sales event with 15,000 employees and declared it again. And then he even declared it at our shareholders meeting. So yes, this is our culture, and this is what is driving us to make a difference. In my conversations with HR leaders and IT leaders, customers often want to know, what is Microsoft HRWeb? What does it look like? What does it represent? How did you all transform that? Here at Microsoft, HRWeb is one of our most critical assets. We have more than 140,000 employees, and we operate in more than 109 countries. And all these employees come to HRWeb to look for information relating to employment, careers, benefits, and rewards, and much more. It is the gateway to other tools and resources for employees. Now, with regards to what it used to look like, here you see we were on SharePoint 2010. This is what our old HRWeb used to look like. As many of you know, SharePoint 2010 had some limitations, and the mobile experience wasn't great. Our custom solutions we deployed created accessibility challenges. Content discoverability was a problem, and our security also became complex. We wanted to migrate to SharePoint Online and take advantage of the SharePoint Online product capabilities to improve the mobile experience and the employee experiences. We wanted to simplify the architecture and leverage Azure Active Directory to support our role-based security model that can scale. We also wanted to make sure that content was discoverable. All these and many other things were things that we wanted to work on. There are several things that I want to share here, which is, once we had a good understanding of what the challenges and the opportunities were, we went back to our leaders and we presented the idea of what we wanted to implement. And right there, our leaders looked at what we wanted to do and unanimously approved for us to proceed. I say this because stakeholder involvement is so critical in everything that we do. We also did what we call internal benchmarking. We went to organizations within Microsoft that have already gone to the cloud, and we asked them, how did you do it? What did you do? What are some of the lessons? We actually brought one of them to our HR leaders for them to present their journey. In April 2017, we kicked off our minimum viable product. We moved a few things to SharePoint Online to see what that's going to look like. And by the end of June, we presented that to the leadership. And once they saw that, they embraced it. By end of October, we have migrated the entire HRWeb to the cloud. We continue to work with other teams, with security, with Microsoft Digital, to make sure that the system, the platform is performant. In April 2018, we released the product to the entire company. Now, when you look at what is on the left and you look at what is on the right, this is a complete transformation from what it used to be. And we are beginning to see our employee satisfaction going up. Today, our HR web is more discoverable in our major portals. It is GDPR and accessibility compliant. The team is working on then upgrading to the next version. So the employee experiences that we delivered is not just something we did and we thought that we were done. This is a continuum and it's very exciting for us. I want to share the experiences of our time and absence reporting tool. Now, here in the United States, employees use this tool to submit their time off. We saw an opportunity to improve on this experience. We decided to use Power Apps to surround this experience. And by deploying this single app, we were able to not only make this application accessible from a mobile device, but we were able to add additional functionality to this app. And because it has worked for us so well, we provided a package of this so that our customers can download and configure in their own environments. So today we have more than 500,000 downloads of this Power Apps starter kit. This right here is what we deployed to address some of those limitations that the on-premise platform has today. Now, the next thing I want to do is I want to show you a quick demo of how this app works. I'm going to type time away right here in Bing. And when I do that, what you see is the results of what I type is really prioritized to the very top, because we wanted to make sure that employees can find what they're looking for when they come to Microsoft Bing or some of our major portals. Here is our time and absence reporting tool that we deployed. When I click on this to open it, here I can see all the information that is available for me and my balances as far as my time and absence reporting goes. If I scroll down a little bit, I can see sick leave and I can see floating holiday and so on. To submit time off, I simply click here, and these are all the things I can do in this application. Right now, I'm going to submit some time off. I click on that, and I'm going to be out of the office January 5th and 6th. I select those dates. Notice that anything that is gray, I cannot book it because that is company holiday. Anything that has a blue dot means that I have already requested that day. If I click continue, and here it gives me a summary of what I am requesting and my new balance, I'm going to go ahead and submit. I click yes. Now, here is what is so beautiful about this. Today, when most employees submit time off, they will go to Outlook to block the time. With this app, you don't have to do any of that. Within the context of the app, I can tell my team that I'll be out of the office. In this case, I want to inform people that I'll be out of the office. I can select them here and then simply notify them. When I do that, I can select my manager and somebody that I work with very closely, call that done, and here you go. And it will, they'll get this message that says that Joseph will be out of the office on this specific day. And all I have to do, send notification, right? I do that. Here's the other thing. The other thing that we all do when we submit time off is turn out of office. We'll go to Outlook to do that. With this app, you don't have to do that. You can simply click right here and then notify people in your organization. Right, what this would do is it would write back to your Outlook calendar and it would block that time. On this specific day, it will send this out of messages to employees when they email you while you're out of the office. And this is a classic example where we use Power Apps to surround our legacy system time and absence reporting without having to rip and replace it. Once we completed the HRWeb migration and time away applications, we went back looking at the data for some of the things that we left behind and the things we wanted to prioritize. We met with our leaders and we say, here are the experiences that we want to go after. And the list included onboarding, employee and manager experiences, and the alumni experience. We met with our leaders and we presented this information and we agreed to prioritize the manager experience. And so we brought managers into one of our buildings for 2 days in partnership with our studio research team, understanding what it is that managers are looking for and how an experience would help them become better at what they do. And this was very exciting. And as I stated in the beginning, executive and leadership support is so critical to everything that we do. So here is the concept and what ManagerHub was all about. ManagerHub really focused on those things that we're hearing from managers. We were able to deploy a platform that allows them to not only see what they need to do, but actions that they need to take. You can see the goals listed here. We also just did not release that to production. We released the minimum viable product and finally released it to the public, meaning to the manager population. And here is what we delivered. A manager dashboard that really focuses on bringing together an aggregated experience to help managers really take action, to learn, to understand, but to be also informed. So here a manager can see his team meeting habits, one-on-one information, time away. Here's a more detailed look at that. Now, here's an example. A manager can look at team one-on-one, and here he can see that three people has less than 1 hour, and he can simply schedule that right there with an employee. And then on the far right, we see team email responsiveness. A manager can see how frequently they respond to one person versus the other. And these insights are meant to help them figure out how they can model good behavior by looking at these insights. In some cases, we refer them where they can go and learn more. In some cases, it's for insights for them to internalize. Here's what's exciting about this. Microsoft Viva Insights takes this to a whole new level. Not only does it show them the insights that they need to see, but it gives them recommendations and best practices that they can look at and figure out the things that they need to do. And for us here at Microsoft, they have a tool that would help them really look at those things that they need to help them model good behavior, coach, and care for their employees. So the manager experience and the manager persona here at Microsoft is very, very critical for us. And we are glad and very excited about what Microsoft Viva Insights is going to offer to these managers. So with the Microsoft Viva Insights, managers now have at their fingertips the tools and the insights they need to be better at what they do. And for us here at Microsoft, because we expect managers to model good behavior, coach and care, Microsoft Viva Insights gives them all that information that they need by looking at that, taking recommended actions, and looking at best practices. And with that, I want to take you now to the list of resources that I want you to have access to for offline reading. Here are some of the links of everything that I shared and everything that I talked about. I want to thank you again for joining us here today at Microsoft. It's been a pleasure sharing some of these stories that we have been working on over the years, and I hope you find them valuable. Thank you for your time.